If you think this aluminum case is just a box, you're wrong. Inside is an innovative secret, pushing the limits of possibilities you have never seen before. Hi guys, wouldn't you all like to enjoy metalworking as soon as you get home from work? This time, I am going to evaluate the performance of this DIY aluminum case made with a crazy concept. I introduce some innovations for metalworking DIY freaks. If you have watched the previous video, you probably know the concept of this DIY aluminum case, but for those of you who are seeing it for the first time, here is a simple explanation. To put it simply, I don't have a workshop of my own, so I decided to put all the functions of a metalworking shop into this case, so that I can enjoy metalworking. I know some of you may think there is no way I could do that. However, as a result of drinking too much, my brain and alcohol had a chemical reaction that awakened me, and like a madman, I completed this tool. It was truly a feat that only a drunk could accomplish. People all over the world were praising this as a historic invention in my dreams. At least, I am the only person who has created such a tool. If you are interested in how it was created, please watch the previous video. If you are new to this channel, you may not realize it, but my voice has also changed. I think this is probably due to my awakening and going beyond common sense. Don't you think my voice is better than before?
It was like this before.
Now, back to the story. Inside this aluminum case, there are a lot of things and tools necessary for metal working. It has the ability to do manual work using a vise, drilling, turning, and milling. Now I need to try each of these features and evaluate their performance to see if I am satisfied with them. I will share it with you so that you can get a feel for what it can do. For example, one person may praise this tool as a once-in-a-century invention. One person might want to buy it for $1,000. One person might want to build something more powerful. Anyway, this is an interesting video for those who are interested in DIY metal working, for those who are poor in working environment, and for those who want to inspire your own imagination. I hope it will have a positive impact on your DIY projects. I will now begin the test machining. The parts to be machined are mainly those for the 5-axis CNC machine currently being manufactured. In the first place, this aluminum case was made to efficiently produce parts for 5-axis CNC machines. So I would like to evaluate its performance by actually making those parts. This 5-axis machine is also quite an inventive machine. If you are interested, I recommend you to watch it from the 5-axis machine project video list. The part I am working on now is the A-axis. I will be making the parts for this part. Let's start. This part is the base plate to which the A-axis worm gear is attached. The machining of such parts can be completed only in this aluminum case without splattering the chips. This is the worm gear used to rotate the A-axis. The center part has already been machined by the red CNC machine. This gear will be mounted on the plate that has just been machined. Next is the bearing housing. Parts that must be machined with high accuracy are machined using this CNC machine. After that, they are cut again in the aluminum case. I will try to correct the poorly made stepper motor bracket I made previously. This bracket was made before the step out measures on the red CNC machine. It is so badly made bracket that I am embarrassed to show it. It is not possible to install the stepper motor correctly. Try cutting 8mm aluminum. Aluminum could easily be cut at 8mm. Next, I will try lathe machining. Let's try turning a 5 15mm steel material. Somehow it seems to be lathed. The depth of cut is very small, about 0.1 millimeter. I think the important thing is that it can be lathed. If I wanted to machine something larger than this, I would use a different lathe. Next, I will try lathing a 5mm steel shaft. This level of lathe work does not seem to be a problem, but I would like to get a more beautiful surface. The 1.5 mm grooving cannot be lathed properly due to completely insufficient machine strength. By 15 millimeters aluminum is also no good due to insufficient power. Lathing of the outer diameter of aluminum does not seem to be a particular problem. Ideally, I would like to be able to do this level of lathing when machining steel. Now that I have a general understanding of the performance of this DIY aluminum case, I would like to use it to complete one of the parts for my 5-axis CNC machine. Which part would be the just best part? I think this part is just right. I will make this in brass. Cut out the material and lathe the outer and inner diameters. It is a very simple part, but I think it is just right. Something is wrong. This sound is something wrong. The bolts holding the X-axis were loose. This would be impossible to process the machine properly. A machine with a lot of vibration is prone to loose bolts. Countermeasures may be necessary. Anyway, I tightened the bolt and tried again. Sounds good. It needs to be able to be processed like this. How was it? Did you enjoy it? In the first place, you may think that this machine is not strong enough or powerful enough, since it focuses on compactness and multifunctionality. With this aluminum case, it was assumed that any machining that could not be done would be done with other specialized machines. In my opinion, it has the minimum performance required. I am not satisfied with the performance related to lathe machining. In particular, groove machining almost did not work. I may modify it again to improve it. Currently, my main project for this channel is to build the 5-axis CNC machine. However, this is my priority, but I have become interested in the ChatGPT. I am also interested in how to use this technology for DIY, and it is taking up a lot of my time. AI is really amazing. The spread of personal computers and the internet was a technological revolution that changed the way the world works. But AI is the biggest technological revolution as far as I know. And this voice is the voice of AI to begin with. I'm thinking of putting out a video about ChatGPT someday. For those who are interested in seeing a video about the 5-axis CNC machine I'm building, I apologize for the delay. ChatGPT and AI research is to improve the efficiency of DIY projects and video production, and to provide you with informative and entertaining videos. I'm trying to post a well-done video every week that will satisfy you all. I will continue to try insane things. If you are interested in this project, I suggest you subscribe to my channel, so you don't miss any videos. If you empathize with my project, why don't you become a member and support this channel? There are a few benefits, but as long as you are a member, your name will appear at the end of the videos as a patron. In other words, you can be a part of this project. So, please look forward to the next video.